I'm an Ikwerre man from River State. Mr. Speaker, my dear colleagues, I will start by reminding us of what one of my pastors said, that we should live our lives in a way that we will not compel our pastor to lie at our funeral. We are aware that it's difficult for people to say evil of the dead. And so even when a bad man dies, at the funeral, people will begin to pour accolades on such a person. But my dear colleagues, here is a woman. Here is one of our own who has lived a life that will not make anybody want to lie when you talk about her. I've listened to the things said about her. Even when this doctorate award was bestowed on her, I could not find anyone that is exaggerated. I've stayed with her for 8 years in these hallowed chambers. She's one that is full of knowledge. If persons like this are given honorary doctorate degrees, I think that those degrees will make meaning. She merits it. Very knowledgeable, very active on the floor of these chambers. In fact, these are the type of persons that a country like Nigeria should emulate, develop claims in democracy to ensure that such persons remain in this arm of government. But it's unfortunate that she's exiting temporarily, though. I believe in this honorary award, and I want to thank the university for picking her out, because I'm sure that they took their time to do a thorough work in identifying her to give her this award. I want to also ask that the kind of life that Honorable Nnenna lives should be one that our younger sisters, our girls, should emulate in the society. And I want to encourage her that what is happening today should also be a challenge. She's doing well. We expect her to continue to do well and, in fact, better what she has done. And I pray that we will also have the opportunity for such good things to be said about us in the way we conduct our affairs and business. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, my dear colleagues.
Honorable Sunday Adepoju.